Now we will see indeterminate trusses, analysis of statically indeterminate trusses. What is indeterminacy? This DS we will see. See, for any truss to be formed, suppose with three joints, and three members, stable structure can be formed. Okay. Stable truss. Three joints. With three members. Suppose fourth member if you want to join, I mean one more joint if you want to provide, so two members are required. Okay, additional joint, two members are required. Another one more joint if you want to provide, two members are required. Okay, so for additional each joint, two members are required for making stable truss. That means initial three joints only one member per joint. Initial three joints, okay. Further, every joint needs two members, okay. That means number of members required to form a stable truss or see, actually, number of members equal to two times of joints. See, if you multiply joints with two, number of members, but initially for three joints, actually six members are not required, okay? Every joint needs two members means initial three joints, actually six members it comes, okay? But we need only three. So that means 2j minus 3. The logic understood, no? First three joint needs only three members, not six members, but further each joint requires two additional members. That means first instead of six we are taking three, that's why 2j minus 3. Okay, two times of joints minus 3, these many members are required to form a stable truss. But support conditions also will be there. So support reactions required for stable truss equal to 3, because sigma h equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, sigma m equal to 0, for that 3 reactions are required. So totally for stable truss, m plus r number of members number of members required and reactions together must be equal to 2j. Okay, m plus r equal to 2j. Example, suppose take this one. This structure, okay, this table one. So reactions are three reactions. So now check it. M equal to here, three. Reactions are equal to three. Joints equal to three. So M plus R equal to 6. 2j equal to 6. So here logic is m plus r equal to 2j, so it is stable. Stable under determinant also. Stable under determinant. I will show you one more structure. Suppose this one. So now how many reactions are there here? Okay, like this, right? So four reactions. Now here number of members equal to two members. Okay, reactions are four, joints are three. Now m plus r equal to 2 plus 4 6. M plus r equal to 2 plus 4. Okay, 6. 2j equal to 2 into 3 6. So m plus r equal to 2j. So stable under determinant. Okay. Now static indeterminacy. DS can be split into DSI plus DSE. That means internal static indeterminacy plus external static indeterminacy. So internal means, see, if number of members are, if m is more than 2j minus 3, then internal static indeterminacy is internal static indeterminacy is m minus of 2j minus 3. M minus of 2j minus 3 is DSI. Okay. Similarly, if number of reactions are more than 3, then external static indeterminacy is r minus 3. Okay. So finally, DS equal to m minus 2j minus 3 plus r minus 3, which is equal to m plus r, okay, minus 2j. M plus r minus 2j is DS, okay, static indeterminacy. Examples. Suppose if you take the stress, number of members equal to horizontal members 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, vertical members 3, 4 plus 3, 7, inclined members 4, so total members are 11, number of joints are only 6, okay, number of reactions are, for hinge joint, every hinge joint, two reactions will be there. So three hinge joints, so six reactions. Okay. So now DSI equal to static indeterminacy, I mean internal indeterminacy, DSI equal to internal, that is m minus 2j minus 3, because for internal stability minimum number of members required are 2j minus 3 members equal to, if it is more than that, then it becomes static internal indeterminacy, that is equal to m is here 11 minus 2j, 2 into joints 6 minus 3, which is equal to 11 minus 12 minus 3 is 9. That equal to 2. So 2 members additionally are there. Okay. So if you remove this one and this one, suppose this member remove and this member you remove, then it becomes, by removing 2 members carefully, you can get statically determinate one you can get. So internal static indeterminacy is 2 here. Similarly, externally actually r minus 3, r here 6 minus 3 3, that means 3 extra reactions are there. Totally ds equal to 2 plus 3, that equal to 5. Okay, so 5 is static indeterminacy for this truss. So now how to analyze this statically indeterminate truss, that we will see. We take simple problem and I will explain you. Okay, suppose this is the truss which is internally indeterminate, ABCD. Okay, here one member extra is there, so that is indeterminate. Okay, something like this. Okay, so how to analyze this means the process. I will explain you the process. Okay, analysis process I will explain you. Step one, assume the force in extra member, because it is statically indeterminate, okay, internally indeterminate. Assume the force in extra member is R. Okay, step two, remove the member and place a force R in place of member. That means suppose BC is the extra member, then what we need to do? Suppose assume tensile force, okay, in that member. R force we are keeping in that direction, okay. We are keeping the force in that direction. Next. So this can be step three. This can be visualized as superposition principle. That is, superposition principle means apply external loads only and apply plus R force, R unit force, okay, times of R. See, unit force times of R, okay. R directly can put R actually in place of 1. R, you put 1 unit load in that, I mean, member direction and multiply with R. That means, that is actually original force in any member equal to due to, I mean, removed, I mean, the extra member removed structure force plus K, unit load replaced, no? So forces you will analyze K into R, K times of R. So F equal to P plus KR. That means suppose FAB, if you want to find PAB plus KAB into R. Okay. That means PAB means here, suppose this is PAB. That means additional member removed structure, whatever is there in that structure, in AB, what force is developing? That is PAB. KAB means unit load placed. Where you need to put unit load? The removed member, wherever, whatever is there, in removed member direction, you are keeping unit load. So because of that, whatever force will develop in AB member, that is KAB. Okay. Then multiplied by R. That's why KAB into R. So original force in AB is equal to PAB plus KAB into R. So that is the final, I mean, final formula to calculate forces in all members. Okay. What is R means? The force in additional member. R is force in additional member. Okay. Now we will develop methodology. Okay. Methodology is like this. So strain energy, you know, strain energy equal to, you know, F square L by 2AE. F square L by 2AE. Okay. So F is here P plus KR. Okay. P plus KR square L by 2AE. Of course, sigma in all members. Okay. This is U. So dou U by dou R equal to sigma of 2 times of P plus KR into KR with respect to R means K into L by 2AE, which is equal to, see, if you differentiate with respect to R, you will get displacement in the direction. Displacement, you know, because of this, because of R force in the member, because of R force in the member, displacement is actually so tensile. So we are giving, I mean, we are assuming force in additional member as tensile. Tensile force means obviously it extends, okay, PL by AE, RL by AE. It's I mean, its displacement will be delta in member R, okay. Delta in member R, which is equal to, I will explain you, sigma into, here 2 gets cancelled, PKL by AE plus sigma of K square L by AE, see R is there here, into R, okay, equal to delta. Delta R is R L by AE. See, L is here length of additional member. AE also related to that only. So we need to finally find R actually. So here delta R, actually we are taking direction we are taking here. We are assuming force in R member is tensile. The forces, because of this force effect, what happens here? Because of this force effect, BC distance decreases, right? Because of this R force effect, what happens? See, we are assuming tensile force. Tensile force means away from joint, right? But we are putting arrow marks like this. Because of this arrow marks, the BC distance decreases. That means delta is going to, I mean, BC length is going to decrease. So, but we are assuming tensile force in BC, but actually BC increases because of tensile force. but because of our force direction, it decreases. So opposite sense we need to consider here. Minus here, minus. Okay. Now, which is equal to okay. Now based on this formula, sigma PKL by AE plus RL by AE equal to minus R into sigma K square L by AE. Finally, R equal to something wrong. R equal to minus of sigma PKL by AE plus RL by AE divided by something wrong, I think. Here this step mistake is there, right? So R is there in two steps, right? Okay. So sigma PKL by AE equal to minus R into sigma K square L by AE. That goes this side, means L naught by AE. Let us assume it is L naught. Which one? This one, L naught. Okay. Then R equal to minus sigma PKL by AE divided by sigma K square L by AE plus L naught by AE. So L naught is here the extra members length. Okay. This is the L naught, extra member length. This is the formula to find R actually. After finding R, force in any member can be, suppose force in IJ member can be determined by force in IJ member due to external loads in member released structure plus KIJ unit load placed structure force, you know, multiplied by R. R already we got here in this formula. This is the formula to find R. So this is the methodology. I will explain you one problem, simple problem, so the same problem only. A equal to constant for all members. Okay. Now I will explain you A, B, C, D. So I will remove one member. While removing that member, the structure must be stable. Okay. Extra member only should be removed. Okay. Suppose I will remove one member like this. Put external load. And analyze this one. So analysis, see 10 into 2, 20 into 2. What is RA, RB? you can work out RB. While in this process, the force in this will be 0 and this force will be 10. Okay. RARB calculation, 10 into 2, taking moment about A plus 20 into 2 equal to RB into 2. RB equal to 30 kilonewtons. 30 kilonewtons. Obviously, here it is 10 kilonewtons down because for summation of vertical forces must be 0. So here it is again 10. Obviously, here it is 10 in this AB member. In this member, compression. Here, what is this member? See, ABCD. BD member, compression will be there, right? Compression 30. Okay. See, naturally, in this member, tension will be there like this. That is because it is 45 degrees. So, 10 root 2.
Sir, AB member 0 kada, sir.
One second. AB member, yeah. AB member, we need to check it. We cannot decide here. Yeah, 10 root to this one. This is 10 root 2. So, horizontal component of this 10 root 2 will be balanced by this, and the force here, otherwise also it will be 0. This is 0. So, this is the analysis for this member. And unit load place structure also we need to analyze. That is, okay. So, in this direction, one unit load we need to put like this. Okay. Now, in this analysis, horizontally, if you analyze at A, B, C, D, at C joint, if you analyze horizontally, so horizontal component should balance with this. That's why it is one horizontal component into cos 45, that is 1 by root 2. So, 1 by root 2 force here, and in AC it must be this also compressive, this also 1 by root 2. Okay. Next, so reactions are 0 actually, no reactions here. 0, 0, 0, no external reactions, only internal force is there, that's why no external reactions. So here, tension should be there in this member like this because vertical component should balance. So obviously it must be one here, one unit, okay, tension. So to at D joint, if you analyze, compression must be there here, that is 1 by root 2. And B joint also, if you see, horizontal component must be balanced. So compression 1 by root 2. This is the analysis of this unit load place the structure. Okay, now calculate all these remaining things. Okay, that is member. Here, if AE is constant in this formula, if AE is same for all members, then R equal to minus sigma pkl by sigma k square l plus l naught. Okay, because A gets cancelled everywhere. Okay, so pkl k square l we need to calculate. Member p k l pkl k square l. Okay, see, members, AB member is there, BD member is there, CD member is there, AC member is there, BC member is there, okay? sorry, AD. AD member is there. AD member is there. Okay. Removed member, you don't consider. Okay. So forces in these members, AB, 0, BD, 30, CD, 10. See, compression take negative, minus 30, minus 10. AC, 0, AD tensile, 10 root 2. So K, unit load place structure, K, compressive, minus 1 by root 2. BD, minus 1 by root 2. CD, minus 1 by root 2. AC, compression, okay, minus 1 by root 2. AD, tensile 1, okay. Lengths, okay. Lengths actually, AB length 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters, AD only 2 root 2. Now, what is PKL? Tell me PKL value. Here 0, this also 0, 2 zeros are there. Okay, remaining PKL 6 minus minus plus 60 by root 2. That is 60 by root 2 means 30 root 2. This is also 20 by root 2. 20 by root 2 means 10 root 2, right? This one 40, right? 40. So what about K square L? K square L. So finally, K square L here, 1, 1, 1, 1, this is 2 root 2. So this is sigma PKL 40 plus 40 root 2. This one sigma K square L equal to 4 plus 2 root 2. So here R equal to minus of sigma PKL by sigma K square L plus L naught, which is equal to minus of 40 plus 40 root 2 by 4 plus 2 root 2 plus L naught is 2 root 2. That is equal to minus 10, right? Minus 10. Okay. Now, force in AB equal to P 0 plus K minus 1 by root 2 into 10. Minus 10. That equal to 10 by root 2 kilonewtons. Tensile, okay. Force in BD equal to minus 30 plus minus 1 by root 2 into minus 10, which is equal to how much? Minus 30 plus 10.
22.93.
And then 22.93.
10 by root 2, how much?
7.07, minus.
Minus 7.07, huh? Force in BD. Force in CD, minus 10 plus minus 1 by root 2 into minus 10 equal to?
Or FAB plus also.
FAB plus.
FBD minus.
FBD minus, okay. FCD?
Minus 2.928.
Okay. FCD. FAC? 0 plus minus 1 by root 2 into minus 10. That is
7.07.
AD?
4.1.
root 2 plus 1 into minus 10 equal to 4.142. 4.142. Okay. Anyway, force in CD, okay? Force in CD is R only. R is minus 10. Okay.
CB.
CB, sorry. This is the final analysis, okay? So now you check once in, using any app, okay? Correctness of this problem, you check once, okay? And you do one more assignment problem. Okay. E is same roll number. Okay. It's all again.